morning, my dear students. Today we are going to learn our lesson. Already I told you story. Now we are going to learn lesson. Your textbook page number 69, unit number 4, the portrait of a lady written by Khushwant Singh. What you have to do? You must have to complete your warm-up activity. And what is your warm-up activity? Already when I told you story, at that time only I told you that warm-up activity. Now I am going to teach you lesson. Textbook page number 69, paragraph number 1. My grandmother, like everybody's grandmother, was an old woman. She had been old and wrinkled for 20 years that I had known her. People said that she had once been young and pretty and even had a husband. But that was hard to believe. My grandfather's portrait hung above the mantelpiece in the drawing room. He wore a big turban and loose fitting clothes. His long white beard covered the best part of his chest and he looked at least 100 years old. He did not look the sort of a person who would have a wife or children. He looked as if he could only have lots and lots of grandchildren. As for my grandmother, being young and pretty, the thought was almost revolting. She often told us of the games she used to play as a child. That seems quite absurd and undevised on her part, and we treated it like the fables of her prophets she used to tell us. He is telling about his grandmother. When his parents left him towards his grandmother for study purpose, for his primary study purpose, he is telling there was a big portrait in their house. And whose portrait it was? It was his grandfather's portrait. In that portrait, his grandfather was looking too old, more than 100 years old he was looking. How he was looking? He was looking more than 100 years old. There was a big turban to his head and his clothes were somewhat loose clothes there. And he is telling people, it was too hard. People used to tell when he went to his grandmother and how he remembering her, how he knowing her, he seen her. There was a wrinkle. There were so many wrinkles on her face. She was somewhat bent. She was a bit fat. And people used to tell him that his grandmother was too pretty and she was too young. When she was too beautiful when she was young and when she was a husband. But he is telling, our writer is telling, it's too difficult and it's too difficult to accept that she was like that. More than 20 years over, he is observing her in that position itself. And he is describing his grandfather whose portrait was hanged on her, on the mantelpiece means middle corner. Everyone can see that place in the house. His grandfather's photo there. And he was looking too old. He has like more than 100 grandchildren are there, like that he is looking. Many times he is telling, my grandmother used to tell us, she was sharing her childhood, how she spent her childhood, which game she used to play, she shared with whom? With our writer, with Khushwant Singh. But we are thinking that whatever she is telling, okay, they not asked her more, he not asked her more, it was looking like a fables. She had always been short and fat and slightly bent. Her face was crisscross of wrinkles running from everywhere to everywhere. No, we were certain she had always been, as we had known her, old. So terribly old that she could not have grown older and had stayed at the same age for 20 years. She could never have been pretty, but she was always beautiful. She hovered about the house of spotless white, with one hand resting on her waist to balance her stoop and the other telling the beads of her rosary. Her silver locks were scattered untidily over the pale, puckered face, and her lips continuously moved in the inaudible prayer. Yes, she was beautiful. She was like the landscape in the mountains, an expanse of pure white serenity, breathing peace and contentment. He is telling, my grandmother, people are telling your grandmother was too pretty. He is telling she was not pretty, but she was beautiful. How I am seeing her, she is like that way. She kept her house very neat because she was living alone. Now who joined along with her? Our writer Khushwant Singh joined along with her. His trailing house was very nice, neat. It was small house, but it was neat house. Whole day she was reciting mantras and mantras and mantras and mantras. Leap movement was grandmother was continuously going on. And what she used to talk, she never used to talk any bad word to others. She never poked her nose in other matter. She never went outside to ask someone else. She never used her mouth to use dirty words for others. In this way, he is telling that my grandmother made herself busy by remembering, by taking, by reciting name of God. My grandmother and I were good friends. My parents left me with her when they went to live in the city, and we were constantly together. She used to wake up in the morning and get me ready for school. She said her morning prayer in the monotone sing song while she bathed and raised me in the hope that I would listen and get to know it by heart. I listened because I loved her voice, but never bothered to learn it. When she would fetch my wooden slate, which she had already washed and plastered with yellow chalk, a tiny earthen pink ink pot and a red pen, tie them all in one bundle and hand it to me. After breakfast of thick stale chapatis with a little butter and a sugar spread on it, we went to school. She carried several stale chapatis with her for the village dogs. When his parents left him towards grandmother, what was his schedule? His grandmother making him to get up from his sleep. But before he is getting from the sleep, she was cleaning the house properly. She was bathing herself and she was reciting again and again mantras. Khushwant Singh is telling he liked to listen it because he liked her voice. But he is telling he never bothered. He tried to listen. He loved to listen, but he never tried to learn it. She was making him to get up, and before making him to get up, she was managing all the things, whatever need for the school. She used to clean his slate. She was keeping near that slate ink pot. His breakfast box was ready near to the school bag. In this way, she was managing everything before he is getting up from the sleep. And when he was going to wake up, she was going along with him to give a bath for him. After bath, she used to give him hot breakfast, which was very delicious, which was very tasty. Who was making that one? That one was making, that was prepared by grandmother. after breakfast. She was taking some chapatis, stale chapatis, stale opposite fresh there. On that chapati, she used to spread some butter and she was spreading some sugar. For whom's sake she used to take these chapatis? She was taking chapatis along with her for dogs. Which dogs? Street dogs. My grandmother always went to school with me because the school was attached to the temple. The priest taught us the alphabet and the morning prayer while the children sat in the rows on other side of the veranda singing the alphabet on the prayer in the chorus. My grandmother sat inside reading the scriptures. When we had both finished, we would walk back together. This time, the village dogs would meet us at the temple door. They followed us to our home, groaning and fighting with each other for the chapatis we threw to them. There was attached, school and temple was attached. Just so you remember olden days school, you ask your grandfather or grandmother. Either school was already you learnt one poem, village schoolmaster. How was that school? It was under the tree. And one teacher only handling all the subjects. But now there is a lot of difference in education system. This writer is telling, he is describing even his school also from this lesson. Where was school? School was attached to the temple only. One side temple, one side school. The priest who was worshipping, who was taking care of the temple, that priest used to teach, working as a teacher for the student. When priest was empty, he used to come tell to teach them alphabet, English alphabet, or whichever language alphabet he used to teach there. And here grandmother was reciting mantras until school is not going to finish. And when school is going to finish, along with his grandson, along with Khushwant Singh, she used to come back to home. And when she was coming back, you know, near to the temple, more monkeys we can see, either monkeys, cows or dogs we can see. And when the school over, when those both were coming back, she used to give that chapati pieces to whom? To the street dog. Those dogs were following them until their house. When my parents were comfortably settled in the city, they sent for us. That it was a turning point in our friendship. Although we shared the same room, my grandmother no longer came to school with me. I used to go to an English school in a motor bus. There were no dogs in the streets and she took to feeding sparrows in the courtyard in our city house. When he is telling, when his parents were settled properly in the town, they came back and they called both of us along with them. Both they went to the town along with their parents. And he is telling it was turning point in our friendship. Because as they shifted to the from village to the town, what happened? She in this village she used to go along with him to the school. But now he, as he joined English medium school, he used to go by the motor bus to the school. And that chance she missed, he too missed to spend some time along with grandmother. And in there were no dogs. Dogs not there. Hardly we can found anyone or two dogs on the street. But rare, not possible. So, she was sitting in the veranda and she used to feed sparrows in their city house. As the years rolled by, we saw less of each other. For some time, she continued to wake up me and get me ready for school. When I came back, She would ask me what the teacher had taught me. I would tell her English words and little things of Western science and learning the law of gravity. Archimedes' principle, the world being round, etc. This made her unhappy. She could not help me with my lessons. She did not believe in the things that they taught at the English school and was distressed that there was no teaching about God and the scriptures. She said nothing, but her silence made disappear. She rarely talked to me after that. Still, there was one thing, those were attached with each other. Every morning, she used to make him to wake up from his sleep. And she was asking when he was coming from the school, what he learned, which lesson he learned. Then he used to tell Archimedes' principle and how is our world, our earth is like it is like round. And whatever he learned in English medium school, he used to share with her. But she was feeling bad after listening to him. Why she was feeling bad? She was telling, you are telling so many things what you learned in English, but I am unable to teach you as you are English medium school. And she was unable to learn and teach and help him in English. She was telling, which education you are taking, it is not good. In your education, those are not teaching you one single thing about God. When I went up to university, I was given a room of my own. The common link of friendship was snapped. My grandmother accepted her solution with resignation. She rarely left her spinning wheel to talk to everyone. From sunrise to sunset, she sat by the wheel spinning and reciting prayers. Only in the afternoon, she relaxed for a while up for the feed the sparrows, while she sat in veranda breaking the bread into the little bits. Hundreds of little birds collected round her, creating a veritable bedlam of sound. Some came and perched on her legs, but she never shooed them away. It used to be the happiest half hour of the day of her. And what he is telling, it was a chance, writer got one chance to go away to abroad, to go away to foreign. The room which were shared by both of them, he left that full room to her grandmother. Now she was unable to walk, so his parents given her wheelchair. Whole day she was sitting in the wheelchair in her room. Khushwant Singh went abroad for his higher studies. She was sitting relaxedly. She was sitting very comfortably in that wheelchair. She was avoiding to talk with others. More she made her dizzy by reciting mantras. Afternoon, sometimes she used to, whole day where she was sitting in the veranda with some breadcrumbs, with some food grains. She used to do. To whom? To the sparrows. So many varieties of birds are going to come towards grandmother to eat that food grain. Some of them was sitting on her. Where? Those were sitting on her bed lamp of different sound. It was making her happy. She never shooed them. She never got angry on those birds. Number of hundreds of sparrows are going to gather there. And it was the happiest half hour of her day. Afternoon time she was taking somewhat rest. Otherwise whole day she was sitting in the veranda reciting mantras. And half an hour she was spending with sparrows and different birds. Those half an hour was the most happiest hours in her life. When I decided to go abroad for further studies, I was sure my grandmother would be upset. I would be away for 5 years, and at her age, one could never tell. But my grandmother could was. She was not even sentimental. She came to leave me at the railway station, but did not talk to show any emotion. Her lips moved in a prayer. Her mind was lost in a prayer. Her fingers were busy telling the beads of her rosary. Silently she kissed my forehead, and when I left, the most imprint as perhaps the last sign of a physical contact between us. And it was a chance to go him to the foreigner. He thought that she will get angry on him. She will feel bad. But she not felt bad. She encouraged him. And she came along with him to the aerodrome. Single word she not talked with him. He seen her lips was reciting, remembering God. There was happiness on her face. And she was counting something, rosary. She was counting rosary on her fingers. Just she went towards Kushwan Singh and she kissed his forehead. It is going to call as a forehead. And writer is telling that was the only physical contact after long days between him and grandmother. So my dear students, remaining lesson I will teach you in the next class. I am going to finish the remaining lesson in the next class. Till then, take care. But what you have to do, you must have to underline difficult words and you have to write their meanings. Till then, take care.